you may have experienced it yourself, or you may have heard people say that Linux is absolutely terrible for legacy application support. This is due to the fact that most of the time, we are dealing with dynamic linking where the dependencies for an application are resolved at runtime, as opposed to static linking where they're resolved at compile time. In the case of dynamic linking, if the libraries on your system change and change to a version that is incompatible with the application, it is now no longer going to be able to find the thing that it actually wants to find. Whereas with static linking, all of that's done before you ever run the application, and most of the time it's going to be fine. Now, a great way to get around this issue is through the use of containerization, where you take the application and you take all of the dependencies it needs and just put them into a nice little bundle. And on Linux, there are a number of different ways to approach this, but one of the very popular ways is through the use of Flatpak. Now, Flatpak isn't just containerization, it is also sandboxing. So it takes a application, it bundles all the dependencies it needs, and also puts it into an environment where it can't access all of your system resources, only certain specific things that it is allowed to access. Now, there are ways to open up the sandbox in a safe way, but that requires an application to actually care about supporting portals and supporting Flatpaks. And recently, I was made aware of something where I do not understand why it exists, but it's something that does. On Flathub, Adobe Reader, and yes, this is full fat Adobe Reader. Don't believe me? Here we have it running. This has SIGBOVIC 2024 open. This is where I found the write-up on programmer socks affecting the quality of your code. Nowadays, something like Adobe Reader is frankly not something you even remotely would want to think about because your web browser acts as a PDF reader. Yeah, you could go and use some standalone one if you care about PDF editing, but if all you want to do is read them, there's not even a point to have a standalone application installed. Now, why am I talking about Adobe Reader as a legacy application? If you're thinking about this from the Windows, macOS, or even Android perspective, this is not legacy whatsoever. Modern versions of those operating systems have versions of Adobe Reader that are still actively being developed. Even older versions still have supported versions. But notice something that is weirdly missing from this list. All of these Windows versions, all of these macOS versions, even Android, but Linux is nowhere on this list. So is this right here maybe running through Wine? That would be a whole lot funnier if that was what was being done. But no, this is the Linux version of Adobe Reader. Now, whilst the supported versions of Adobe Reader are on the 24.x series, this is a little bit older. This is on the 9.x series because this was last updated 2013. This is the very latest version of Adobe Reader released for Linux, the version from 11 years ago. This is a time capsule for what Adobe Reader once was. And this is the power of containerization and the power of Flatpak, an application over a decade old that has been long since abandoned, still mostly works, at least for its core functionality. Now, because it's also in a sandbox, you have additional sandbox problems, and we'll go over those in just a moment, but at least for just reading PDF files, it pretty much does what it needs to do. With that being said, this is in absolutely no way supported by Adobe. This is an unverified application. It specifically says here, this software is unmaintained by the vendor and may contain security vulnerabilities. This wrapper is not verified by, affiliated with, or supported by Adobe. This is just someone who decided to go and do this. So they did it. Now, frankly, Adobe Reader was never a good application to begin with. There are much, much better options. It always been like really slow, and this was the application that made me hate PDF files. I thought they were a waste of time. I didn't understand why anybody liked them. Then I tried a different PDF reader. My life changed. I didn't realize the only reason I hated them is because this application is made by a psychopath who hates you and wants you to hate PDF files as well. Now, because it's so old and because it's in a sandbox, there are a lot of things that just don't behave exactly correctly. If we go to this button right here, which for some reason it's opening the tooltip on my other monitor, that's just a Wayland thing. It says click to create PDF using acrobat.com. Clicking that crashes the application. So let's go and reopen that one. Also, you can notice it's dumping out lots and lots of errors over here, which is always very fun to see. Another way we can crash it is go into document, go into security settings, and import security settings. Why does that crash it? I do not know. Other buttons, though, don't necessarily crash it. They just don't really do anything. If we go to the, under file, go to attach to email, that just doesn't do anything. It's not because I just don't have anything open. If we do it here, go to attached email, it just isn't doing anything. Along with that, going to document, sign, and then sign document, also just doesn't do anything. So with the application being in the state that it's in, where like a lot of the functionality just frankly doesn't work, it's kind of funny to me that somebody went out of their way to actually try to preserve this, because it's one thing if you try to preserve an application that people actually care about. Adobe Reader, at least from my experience, is not one of those applications. Now, whilst this is new to me, this is by no means new to Flathub. Yes, the latest build is from 10 days ago, but it is much, much older than that. If we go to the statistics, there are actually people that are downloading this Flatpak. Now, my hope is they find out about it. They're like, there's no way this is actually Adobe Reader. They go and install it, and hey, look, it's Adobe Reader. My actual prediction, though, is this is people from over on Windows who, I guess, either liked Adobe Reader or knew about Adobe Reader, and they wanted the PDF reader on Linux. So, they searched for it, and this is what they came across. Those people are going to have an absolutely terrible experience because it's just not very good, but hey, I guess maybe they're happy? They're probably not happy though. Now, whilst the application itself is proprietary, when it comes to the build script to make the Flatpak, all of that stuff is done in an open source way. If we go to the links, go to the manifest link, this is the build script for generating the Flatpak. And this repo has 18 commits in it. Let's go back to the very first one. That is from 2017, April 20th, by Matthias Klassen and Alex Larson. Now, this commit had literally nothing in it. This is not actually the start of this Flatpak being made. I am not entirely sure why this exists. My best possible guess is they didn't want anyone to come along and try to squat on the name Adobe Reader who wasn't actually trying to package Adobe Reader, so that if someone in the future maybe Adobe wanted to come along and actually make the package themselves, the name would be there already so they could go and use it, and it wouldn't have to be taken off somebody else who was already trying to do so. That logically makes sense, but this is still 4 years after the latest version of Adobe Reader on Linux. So the chance of there being a Linux Flatpak at that point was basically zero. And this repo existed in this weird empty state for 6 more years until the actual first commit was made on April 19th, 2023. This was done by Henry Menk. Now, being a completely abandoned proprietary application, there's not that many things you can do to it, right? You can't start supporting portals. Basically, all you can do is mess around with the Flatpak permission system, make sure you're using up-to-date dependencies, make sure everything is bundled correctly, and that's pretty much the best that you can get. And over the years, very minor changes have been made, updating runtimes and things like that, and it kind of works today. Not great, but it kind of does. But the important question is, should you use it? God no. Even if Adobe Reader was still being updated on Linux, it is by far the worst PDF reader that was ever made. It's always been horrendously slow. And if you just need a reader, just use your web browser. If you need a full editor, there are better applications to use for that as well. But to make matters worse, because it has not been updated, you have an 11-year-old PDF reader with 11 years of unpatched security vulnerabilities. I don't know how many people realize this, but PDFs are a massive malware vector. And unless you know for a fact that a document is safe, I would not be opening it in this application. Yes, it's in the sandbox, so because of the way it's handling its files, you can only access files within your documents folder. So I guess if there's nothing important in there and it does really bad things, it's probably gonna be fine. But like, I wouldn't risk it anyway. But this is just a fun little bit of Linux history that can now be retained forever. And if for some reason you want to go and run it, it's available in Flathub and you can go do so. The instructions are right here to how to install it. I wouldn't recommend you do so, but it is there if it is something that you want to go and do. So let me know down below. Did you know that this exists on Flathub? And if you did, have you used it? I really hope you haven't, but I'd like to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Libera Pay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and please, just don't use it. What's this?